टीवी थोड़ा शिफ्ट कर दीजिए। Hello and welcome to Cricket Carnival T20. I'm Uday Pratap Singh. This is the show that gets you the best and the latest from the ongoing IPL 2017. Yes, the extravaganza continues. We're going to be discussing about match number 33 between Punjab and Hyderabad. Also on the result of today's match between Delhi and Kolkata. Kolkata's triumph. We'll be analysing that in just a bit. We'll also be talking about Bangalore. Have they absolutely failed as a unit? Are they virtually out of the IPL? Virat Kohli was very hopeful in that post-match presentation. I heard him last night. But is it too little, too late now left for them to do? Or rather, too much, if I can correct myself, too much, too late, as they, of course, have lost to Gujarat in yesterday's match. Disastrous earlier as well. Can they swing things around? We'll analyse also on how the current points table looks like. But first up, I want to go straight across, if I can, to someone I spoke to earlier in the day. Purple cap holder, star bowler for Hyderabad, Bhuvneshwar Kumar, who is joining us live. We also have Anshuman Gaikwad, former Indian cricket team coach with us. Welcome to the show, sir. Sabah Kareem, former Indian selector, also live with us from Mumbai. But first, I want to play out that interview which I did with Bhuvneshwar Kumar earlier in the day. Bhuvi, I started out by asking him, bilkul hi badhiya aapka performance raha hai IPL season 10 mein. You're also a continuous holder of the purple cap. Is cheez ke bare mein aap kya kahenge? What do you want to say about this, Bhuvi?
Ye kafi khush hu ki jaisa performance abhi chal raha hai kyunki IPL mein kyunki main baat hai ki mera aim nahi hai purple cap jeetna, but agar aap acha contribute karte ho to wo jaise ek reward hai purple cap ke liye. To सबसे बड़ी बात है कि मैं टीम के जीत में कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा हूँ, वो सबसे अहम बोलूंगा कि हिस्सा है करना, क्योंकि आप जब भी खेलते हैं वो टीम को जिताने के लिए खेलते हैं, तो जिस हिसाब से परफॉर्मेंस चल रही है उस हिसाब से मैं काफी खुश हूँ अभी.
आपकी डिलीवरीज का कंटिन्यूस स्पीड मूवी चल रहा है 140 का पास एक साल से, खास करके इस IPL सीजन में. आप कुछ एक्स्ट्रा ट्रेनिंग ले रहे हैं इस स्पीड के लिए, इस कंसिस्टेंसी के लिए?
नहीं, मैं थोड़ा जिम में ट्रेनिंग चेंज किया उसके लिए, बट मैंने इसलिए चेंज नहीं किया कि स्पीड बढ़ेगा, बट कहीं ना कहीं वो ट्रेनिंग चेंज होने के बाद मुझे काफी हेल्प हुआ स्पीड बढ़ाने में. तो सिर्फ मैंने जिम ही नहीं किया है, तो ग्राउंड का वर्कआउट जिम में या सब चीजें जो भी सबका बैलेंस बना के मैंने किया. तो सबसे बड़ी बात की जो पहले इंडियन टीम के ट्रेनर थे मिस्टर शंकर बासु, उन्होंने काफी हेल्प की मेरी, तो मैं उन्हें क्रेडिट दूंगा कि उन्होंने तो मुझे पहले से ज्यादा फिट किया, तो कहीं ना कहीं वो उस फिटनेस बढ़ने के साथ साथ ही पेस बढ़ी.
यू नो, बट भुवनेश्वर, यूजुअली व्हेन पेस बोलर्स रन आफ्टर स्पीड दे समटाइम्स लूज देयर स्विंग, बट आप माने जाते हैं स्विंग के राजा, तो ये कैसे मैनेज कर देते हैं आप, दिस कंसिस्टेंसी एंड दिस बैलेंस?
बिल्कुल, मैं हमेशा से पेस बढ़ाना चाहता था, स्पेशली इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेट में डेब्यू होने के बाद, क्योंकि अब डोमेस्टिक खेलते रहते हैं 120-130 डालते रहते हैं, डोमेस्टिक के हिसाब से वो इनफ है स्विंग के साथ 130, बट अब जब आप इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेट में आते हैं तो आपको रियलाइज होता है कि स्विंग जरूरी है. एक मुझे लगता है स्विंग पेस से ज्यादा जरूरी है, बट अगर आप सिर्फ और सिर्फ स्विंग होगी और पेस थोड़ा बहुत नहीं होगा, तो कहीं ना कहीं बैट्समैन मैनेज कर लेते हैं वो चीज़ को. उसके बाद मेरे दिमाग में कहीं ना कहीं था कि मुझे पेस बढ़ाना है, बट ऐसा कभी नहीं था कि मुझे पेस के साथ जाना है स्विंग खत्म करके. तो पिछले एक साल से जो पेस इंप्रूव हुआ काफ़ी और साथ में स्विंग भी है, तो वो चीज़ मुझे काफ़ी हेल्प कर रही है विकेट लेने में. बट हाँ, मेरा ऐसा कोई भी एम नहीं है कि मुझे 145, 150 या 140 रेगुलर डालना है अपना स्विंग खत्म करके. जो मेरा एम है कि मुझे 135 to 140 के बीच में डालने का एम है स्विंग के साथ.
जी अच्छा, आपकी जो कैप्टन है डेविड वॉर्नर, वो काफी सराहे जा रहे हैं. ऑफ कोर्स वो उमदा खिलाड़ी हैं ऑस्ट्रेलिया के लिए, आपके कैप्टन हैं, वो आपको बहुत ट्रस्ट करते हैं बॉलिंग के साथ. डेथ ओवर्स में खास करके, तो जरा बताएंगे कि आपके टीम का एटमॉस्फेयर क्या है, स्ट्रेटजी क्या है, कैसे चल रहे हैं आप? प्लेऑफ्स ऑफ कोर्स पे नजर तो है, मगर स्ट्रेटजी क्या है आपकी टीम की? भूवी
नहीं, बिल्कुल, अगर आप पहले सनराइजर्स टीम की बात करेंगे तो हम लोग अभी बहुत अच्छा भी नहीं खेल रहे हैं, बहुत बुरा भी नहीं खेल रहे हैं, क्योंकि सबसे लास्ट ईयर कंपेयर करेंगे तो, बट लास्ट ईयर भी जो हमने अपना बेस्ट क्रिकेट खेला था एज अ टीम, वो हमने टूर्नामेंट के सेकेंड हाफ में खेला था, तो अभी भी सेकेंड हाफ शुरू हो गया है, तो अगर हमें क्वालिफाई करना है प्लेऑफ्स में तो मुझे लगता है कि हमें अपना बेस्ट क्रिकेट खेलना पड़ेगा। फिर आप डेविड वॉर्नर की बात करेंगे तो लास्ट ईयर भी उन्होंने काफ़ी अच्छी कैप्टनसी की, जैसे आपने बोला कि बॉलर्स कैप्टन, मैं बोलूंगा बिल्कुल हाँ, वो बॉलर्स कैप्टन है, क्योंकि उनसे कुछ भी बात करो या अगर उन्हें कुछ प्लान बताओ तो वो पहला चॉइस बॉलर को ही देता है कि ठीक है आप अपने हिसाब से करो जो करना है, उसके बाद जो भी चीज़ें फेवर में जाती है या नहीं जाती है तो उसके हिसाब से चीज़ें चेंज होती है। बट अभी तक लास्ट ईयर भी देखेंगे, उससे पहले दो तीन साल भी और इस साल भी काफ़ी अच्छा माहौल है टीम का, ऐसा कभी नहीं लगता कि हम लोग मैच हारने के बाद भी प्रेशर में है या कुछ हमें चीज़ें अलग करनी है।
ओके, एंड चैंपियंस ट्रॉफी इज ऑल्सो अराउंड द कॉर्नर, एक कंट्रोवर्सी भी आ गई, उसके बारे में कुछ बाद में बात करेंगे, आपसे नहीं पूछूंगा कुछ सवाल भूवी, मगर आपका प्रिपरेशन क्या है चैंपियंस ट्रॉफी के लिए? टीम इंडिया क्या तैयार है? चैलेंज तो बहुत बड़ा होगा, मगर टीम इंडिया क्या रेडी है इस मुकाबले के लिए? आपकी क्या तैयारी है कुछ खास?
इंग्लैंड काफी एक अच्छी कंट्री है अगर फास्ट बॉलर्स की बात करें तो, क्योंकि वहाँ पे स्विंग होता है कहीं ना कहीं ठंडा मौसम रहता है तो वो हेल्प करता है बॉलर्स के लिए। और लास्ट ईयर की काफ़ी अच्छी मेमोरीज हैं कि सारे मैचेस हम जीते, चैंपियंस ट्रॉफी जीते, क्योंकि एक आईसीसी का टूर्नामेंट जीतना अपने आप में ही एक बहुत बहुत मायने रखता है, तो इस साल भी कोशिश करेंगे वही चीज़ें हम रिपीट करें जैसा पिछले साल किया, जो बेसिक्स चीज़ें थी वो सारी करें और पूरा टूर्नामेंट फिर से हम जीते।
ओके, भुवनेश्वर कुमार, थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस, thanks very much for giving us time, of course, earlier in the day. Okay, quick thoughts from you, Anshuman, before we move on to our next talking point on Bhuvneshwar Kumar. You worked earlier also with the pace bowlers of our country, building up an attack on that front, and Bhuvi is just an absolute brilliant find, of course, for Team India, for Hyderabad, specifically in the death bowlers. As he said, he's maintained a balance between his swing and his pace.
Absolutely. Uday, I'll tell you what. I've seen Srinath, I've seen Venkatesh Prasad, I've seen Zahir Khan, you all, when I was coach, they all were there. And bowling quick, yes, Srinath was quick, Zahir was really quick when they came in. Bhuvi, what we've seen that, well, we always thought that he was a good swing bowler. But the way he has been bowling now, consistently at 135, 138, 140, now that is something which is so important in international, the way he said that 120 and 130 will not work. Now, having done that, we always thought, and it happens to everyone, that when you try and bowl quick or you start getting quicker or bowling quicker, you tend to lose your line and length as well. But in his case, no. He's been accurate. You see bowling Yorkers consistently well. And other thing is, when you try and push the ball too hard through the air, you tend to lose the swing. But he has maintained both. Which is amazing, and he's done that in a very short time. Whether he's talking about his fitness, which has helped him, whether it's bowling and efforts that he's put in, I think he's tremendous. That quick, sort of encouraging performance is not so much so that you see in international cricket in such a short time.
Okay, well, that's indeed a very correct assessment, analysis of Bhuvneshwar Kumar. Let's hope he also clicks tonight. Remember, he will, of course, be playing in that game of Hyderabad. We'll be talking about it in just a bit. But first, a big news point from last night. The disaster of Bangalore, who just have not been able to come back in the tournament. It was certainly an all-round performance by Gujarat, though. Full credit to them. They thrashed the RCB by 7 wickets in 13 and a half overs at the Chinnaswamy Stadium. Despite Gujarat's early losses, Aaron Finch scored his 12th IPL half-century, where he smashed 72 runs in just 34 deliveries, blasting the Bangalore players to all corners of the park. It was the fastest half-century by any Gujarat batsman in the two seasons of the tournament they participated in. While for Bangalore, Samuel Badri, who picked up both the openers, finished 2 for 29 in the three overs, however, it just wasn't enough. On top of the game, from the very beginning, Gujarat didn't allow Bangalore to settle down. After this win, Gujarat now climb up to the sixth position with 6 points, one place above Bangalore. They still have, of course, a lot to do. Very quickly, just listen in to what Aaron Finch had to say after his marvelous performance against Team Bangalore. And then we'll come back, of course, and analyze the disastrous showing of Bangalore and whether this could change things in favor of Gujarat, who also, remember, need a lot more wins if they want to make the playoffs. Listen in to Aaron Finch's first.
Yeah, it was a very good performance from the team tonight. I think that if we look through our season so far, there's been games when we've bowled well but then haven't batted well, and vice versa. There's been games when we've just haven't got it all right. But tonight we took a couple of sharp chances in the field, which helps your bowlers a lot. And I think going forward, we're still very confident that we can make the playoffs. Last year we won 6 of our first 7 games. We're probably in a position now where we need to win 5 of our last 6. So that doesn't really change. We knew coming into this game that every game is so important, and we've put ourselves in that position by being poor in a couple of games.
True. You know, and obviously things going very right for Aaron Finch. Saba, though, very wrong for RCB. What's really going wrong for them, according to Saba?
Well, I think this has been the toughest IPL for RCB so far in the past 10 editions. And it seemed that virtually they're out of the contention for the playoffs at this stage. It's highly unlikely that RCB can stage a recovery or can stage a comeback and get into the playoffs. I feel that broadly one can categorize the factors into 5 main points. Number one is initially they were plagued by injuries, so it's very difficult for them to get off to a good note. Second, last season 72% of the runs were scored by these three players, Virat Kohli, AB de Villiers and KL Rahul. And since this season KL Rahul is out of injury, the onus was on AB de Villiers and Virat Kohli to put up those runs on board. Plus, with the addition of Chris Gayle, they've expected to perform, at least score about 65 to 70% of the runs for RCB. That has not happened, and that is one reason why RCB finds itself in such a position at this stage of IPL.
What's really gone wrong for RCB, according to Anshuman? They have a great team on paper. You know, they have a captain who the entire
they are going wrong. They went made sure that I went wrong because I said
you were backing them.
I was backing them. And well, looking like I said, when we predict something, you look at the players and their performance and their potential to go out there and perform. Yeah. Now that is very important for any team. Mm-hmm. Well, look at KKR.
Absolutely.
You know, they have got similar side as RCB. Mm-hmm. Great players, but they are doing it.
Yeah.
Where RCB is struggling, meaning either they are trying to hurry up too much, you know, their batsmen trying to play shots too early. Look at KKR. You have Gautam Gambhir and the opening player or top number three. Three batsmen are doing the job, the entire job. Yeah. They are not leaving it to the middle order or lower middle order. But here, it looks as if they want to finish it everything, you know, in 10 overs.
You know, individually, they're all great players, but as a unit, they're not coming together.
Well, you look at two things. Yeah. As a coach, I would say that, you know...
Despite Badri doing well yesterday.
Yeah, fair enough. But that's probably too late, in the game. The fact remains that once you want to go out there and perform and get the best of the players, individual performances do count. But ultimately, it's collective. You know what 11 players do on the ground, whether it's batting or bowling. But they have to go out there and perform. Here, the problem with RCB, I look at it, that they are not performing, whether individual or collectively. Mm-hmm. And that has been their biggest problem.
Absolutely, that's been their biggest problem. It's not let them come back in the tournament. Kohli, as I said earlier, is still hopeful. But is it just too late? I think so, and probably analysts will also agree with me. Okay, on to our next news point now. Now, a big story that, of course, came in earlier today, something that I referred to earlier in my interview with Bhuvneshwar Kumar, the BCCI seriously contemplating pulling out of the trophy. This after being routed at the voting table where the ICC slashed India's share of global revenue. Sources telling NewsX that the Indian Cricket Board will likely vote against India's participation soon. It's important to note that India missed the April 25th deadline to submit the squad for the Champions Trophy, even as all other 7 participating countries have announced their squads. The BCCI has clearly miffed at the ICC, undervaluing India's contribution to global cricket revenues and not postponing the vote that literally halved BCCI's potential income from the ICC's financial pot. NewsX learns a special general meeting is likely to be called soon, where the members will likely vote for a boycott of the Champions Trophy. So that, of course, is the big news coming in. Anshuman, hearing this news, which is breaking, what's your first thought?
Well, Uday, I don't know. I mean, you have to really know the exact problems and, you know, the sorting out of those problems and what is going on within the BCCI or the ICC, between them. I would only say one thing, that after all, Uday, it's cricket. Mm-hmm. Everyone has to keep only one thing in mind, that whatever you're doing, whether it's money or it's administration or whatever, it is basically cricket. Mm-hmm. If you don't look after cricket, doesn't matter how much money you get. Mm-hmm. I think there's a problem.
Okay, so the good of the game should be looked at. Mm-hmm. That's your first thought, of course, on this story. Quickly, I want to pull out the points table if we can now. Switching our focus back very quickly to the IPL. Let's pull out the points table. Where do things stand right now? We can quickly get it up, the points table, so we can analyze it. Things, of course, looking very good for Mumbai Indians. Okay, we clearly can't get the points table up. We'll try and get it up a bit later on in the show. But a quick look at some other developments from the IPL. Indian cricketer Gautam Gambhir, who's always vocal about issues regarding India's armed forces, has announced that his foundation would pay for all the education expenses for children of 25 CRPF personnel martyred in an attack by Maoists in Chhattisgarh, South Sukma area. Great move, Gautam. We really must congratulate you for this. In another development, West Indian all-rounder Darren Sammy, who missed the first 3 weeks of the IPL due to injury, has joined the Maxwell-led team Punjab squad on the eve of the first match in Mohali this season. Will he play tonight? We'll get you an update in our next segment. Finally, the 10th season of the IPL saw a 7.5% decline in viewership in its third week. IPL matches played between the 15th of April and 21st of April recorded 214 million impressions compared to 231.3 million impressions in the previous week, according to the Broadcast Audience Research Council India. What's leading to that? Well, there's something to ponder for the IPL Governing Council. Let's take a break on that note. We'll be back with lots more. Remember, Punjab versus Hyderabad is the big match on the other side. We've already spoken to Bhuvneshwar Kumar. Can he click? What's the decision being taken? Who's bowling first? Who's batting first? We'll get you more on that in just a few minutes. From the break, you're watching IPL Cricket Carnival T20. Let's go straight across now to the big preview for today. Remember, it's a big game between Hyderabad and Punjab. Sabha, it's a big game for them. Will their confidence help them get a victory against Punjab, who are having a mixed form? They really need to win today because they're languishing out of the top four for now. They need to get their act in order. Sabha.
It is a big game for Hyderabad, but I feel that they have enough potential, enough talented players, enough match winners in their team that can do well and then can beat Kings XI Punjab even at Mohali. They have a solid combination of batsmen. They have David Warner, Shikhar Dhawan, Kane Williamson has come good for them. And then in their, if they look at their bowling, Bhuvneshwar Kumar again is a purple cap holder, has been so precise with his line and length and so effective with the new ball as well as with the old ball. Siddharth Kaul slowly trying to gain from the experience of playing in IPL. So he has come good for them. So they do have the right kind of combination. I think what matters in this game is how Kings XI bat. If they can bat and they can post a big score, then I think it will be difficult for Sunrisers to chase. So what happened in the last game when Hashim Amla put up some big runs on board, so that allowed them to post a big score. If they can manage to do so even today against Sunrisers, I'm sure they'll be in a strong position to give a fight to Sunrisers. And we can see
news coming in from Mohali, which is that Kings XI Punjab have won the toss and chosen to field. So Sabha, of course, was talking about a big score and getting Hyderabad to chase, but they've chosen to do it the other way. Yes. They've chosen to field to chase Hyderabad's total.
Yeah, surely. Meaning, I think whatever Sabha said was something different on different grounds.
Yeah.
But when Punjab has thought of it, I think they would prefer to chase.
Yeah.
You know, because they don't want to give a target to Hyderabad, because they have good batting lineup. The players are informed. Yuvraj is back in the side. Well, Ashish Nehra, again, a seasoned campaigner. So they have fairly balanced and strong side. So probably they want to get a target for themselves and then chase it.
Yeah.
They would be in a better place.
Yeah, true. And a few other changes, a few other breaking updates coming in, which I'll update our viewers and get a quick reaction from Anshuman Gaikwad as well. So Ashish Nehra is back in the squad. He's been missing for a while. Remember, he had a sore neck. He's back. Yuvraj Singh also will be playing tonight. Meanwhile, for Punjab, Amla is out, forced out with a hamstring injury. So that's something which will have to be looked at, because remember, Amla is in formidable form. Punjab will certainly miss him today. Could it also lead to him missing the next couple of matches? Natarajan, meanwhile, is also sore. He also steps out. Morgan Guptill come in, and Anurith Ishan also round up the bowling. So that's the news coming in as far as the team changes are concerned. Quick update, quick reaction from you. Well, Amla definitely will be.
Yeah, definitely. Big time player. And he's an asset to any side. And he's proved it. So there's no question. But I'm sure Guptill coming in, probably he'll also try and compensate. But all these guys have to step up, you know, if they want to win. Unlike RCB, winning, it was disappointing the way they have been batting. They have big names, but none of them are clicking. Yep. Here, now both the teams, it's important for Hyderabad to stay at number three, and it's important for Punjab to win, to go up the ladder, so they have better chances of playoff.
Absolutely. Well, in fact, Nehra coming in as well will complement Hyderabad's bowling, clearly Saba. But Bhuvneshwar, Rashid, they will see them having an impact in the match.
Bhuvi and Rashid, so far for SRH, have been the match winners. They are the wicket-taking bowlers. They are the attacking options that is available for David Warner. Bhuvi has been instrumental in picking up wickets with the new ball. He's the go-to bowler in the death overs also, is extremely frugal, very miserly, and has been able to pick wickets whenever Sunrisers expect him to do well. Rashid Khan, again, has surprised everybody, but now one can see the reason why he has surprised a lot of batsmen in IPL, because he has such a well-disguised variety of googly, the ball which even does not turn, that gets pace off the wicket. He has a mean flipper, which very few people have been able to read. So these are the strength of Rashid Khan. So yes, I do expect both Bhuvneshwar Kumar and Rashid Khan to have a strong impact in today's game as well.
Okay, from Bhuvi to UV now. UV also coming in the match. He's stabilized the Hyderabad innings when they needed him early in the tournament. So how do you see
it? He's always done that. Yeah. He's always done that. It's amazing. Meaning, hats off to him. See, there nobody gets younger. Mm-hmm. You know, get older, your reflexes go down, your footwork doesn't work at times. But the way UV has been performing, and he's gone through hell. Mm-hmm. You know, he had to really work hard to get back to international cricket. We all know about it. And I feel that, he's even staying at the wicket and creating partnerships would be a big help for Hyderabad.
Absolutely. Now, of course, Punjab will be chasing. They do have a very strong, formidable batting lineup, but they're also prone to it collapsing. You know, they're over-reliance on certain players. See, and when it doesn't click, then that could cost them. If Hyderabad posts to be
that if and but is a dangerous, these are dangerous words. Yeah. But the fact remains that, when we talk about it, we expect them to go and perform. When they are chosen in the 11 to play a particular game against a particular team, like Punjab you're talking about, and they're playing strong Hyderabad team, they are number three on the table. Now, you expect the Punjab to step up, go there, and the individual players have to take the responsibility, go out there and perform, whether it's batting or bowling. Like KKR, just take a leaf out of their book. And you will know what to do.
Absolutely. Well, you said you were backing Bangalore yesterday, Anshuman, so I'm going to ask you to end by sticking your neck out and telling us who has the slight edge to this.
Slight edge? I'm going the other way around now. Okay. Punjab.
Okay. Punjab. Ritinder Sodhi will be happy hearing that.
It's their home wicket.
It's their home ground. Yeah. And I'm sure Ritinder Sodhi will be happy hearing that.
Yeah, you are.
I hope he's watching NewsX. But we leave it at that. Thank you so much, Anshuman Gaikwad and Sabah Karim, for being live with us.